Hello, in the earlier lecture, we have seen what is Rayleigh-Jean's law, what is Wien's law, and what is Planck's law. And so I have shared the link for that earlier lecture in my description box. Today we are going to derive how we can reduce the Planck's formula at longer wavelength to Rayleigh-Jean's law. And also how we can reduce the Planck's formula to Wien's displacement law at shorter wavelengths. Okay, so let's begin. So Planck's formula, it is given, show that for longer wavelengths it approaches Rayleigh-Jean's law. So we have for very large values of C2 upon lambda t, for very large values of lambda, if lambda will be more, C2 upon lambda t becomes very small. Okay, so if lambda will be more, then C2 upon lambda t, it will be very small. And we have a formula for small values of x. The formula is e raised to x equals to 1 plus x. So for this, we can write that way. So we will get e lambda, it is equals to C1 lambda raised to minus 5. Instead of e raised to C2 upon lambda t, I can write 1 plus C2 upon lambda t and minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 will get cancelled. So I will get C1 lambda raised to minus 5 lambda t. This lambda t will go up upon C2. So I will get e lambda. It is equals to, suppose C1 upon C2, it is new constant. I denote it by C. And lambda raised to minus 5 lambda, so that will become lambda raised to minus 4, which I will take in the denominator, so that it will be plus 4, okay, into t. So I am getting ct upon lambda raised to 4. So we know that the formula for Rayleigh-Jean's law, it is same, e lambda equals to ct upon lambda 4, or it is 8 pi kt. Rayleigh-Jean's law is E lambda equals to 8 pi kT upon lambda raised to 4. So if you compare this equation and this equation, we will get C, it is nothing but 8 pi k. So hence we can prove that at large values of lambda or at longer wavelengths, we can reduce Planck's formula to Rayleigh-Jean's law. Now let us check the second one, Wien's displacement law. So we have to show that we can deduce Wien's displacement law from Planck's law for shorter wavelengths. Formula is given for Planck's formula. Now for very short wavelengths, lambda is very small, e raised to C2 upon lambda t, it will be very large, because lambda is less, C2 upon lambda t will be more. So e raised to C2 upon lambda t will be very, very large. So we can neglect 1 as compared to e raised to C2 upon lambda t. So what we will have, e raised to lambda, e lambda, it is equals to C1 lambda raised to minus 5. This minus 1 won't be there. So we will get just e raised to C2 upon lambda t. So it will go up. I can write e raised to minus C2 upon lambda t. So I am getting this expression. So let maximum energy is radiated at lambda m. So d, we can write de lambda upon d lambda at lambda equals to lambda equals to 0. Maximum energy is radiated, that means derivative of energy with respect to wavelength, it will be 0 at lambda equals to lambda m. So we will have to differentiate this equation. So d upon d lambda, e lambda ki value we will substitute, c1 lambda raised to minus 5 e raised to minus C2 upon lambda t. This is at lambda equals to lambda m, and this is equals to 0. So C1 is constant, we will take outside. Lambda raised to minus 5 ka lambda raised first function as it is, derivative of second function. E raised to minus C2 upon lambda t, it will be e raised to minus C2 upon lambda t. And again minus C2 upon lambda t ka differentiation, which will be minus C2 upon lambda as it is constant, and derivative of 1 by C2 upon lambda t is constant, and derivative of 1 by lambda, it will be minus 1 upon lambda square. So we are getting this. This is the first term. Then plus second term, as second term as it is minus c2 upon lambda t. Derivative of lambda raised to minus 5. So it will be minus 5 lambda raised to minus 6 at lambda equals to lambda m. This is equals to 0. So what we are getting here, c1. But we are getting c1, c2. C1, C2, lambda raised to minus 5, lambda square. So it will become lambda raised to minus 7. E raised to minus C2 upon lambda t, it will get cancelled from the both the terms. So we will get minus 7. C1, C2 upon t also we will get. Now this t will be there. C1, C2 upon t minus minus became plus. Lambda raised to minus 5, lambda square. That will become lambda raised to minus 7. Plus C1 minus 5. Lambda raised to minus 6 at lambda equals to lambda m equals to 0. So C1 is also getting cancelled from both the terms. And so we are getting C2 lambda raised to minus 7. It is equals to my 5 times T lambda raised to minus 6 at lambda equals to lambda m equals to 0. So we are getting C2 lambda m equals to 5t, or I can write 5t c2 lambda raised to minus 1, minus 7 plus 6, so minus 1, it is equals to 5t. So I can shift this lambda m to that side, or lambda m into t equals to c2 upon 5. So c2 upon 5, suppose it is mu constant, so we will get lambda m into t equals to constant. So basically we are getting lambda m into t equals to constant, which is nothing but Wien's displacement law. So we have deduced Planck's law, we have deduced Wien's displacement law from the Planck's law, hence proved.